Ever looked up at the sky and thought, boy, those clouds must weigh a ton? Well, you're not far off, my friend. You see, those fluffy cotton-like clouds floating across the sky are not as light as they appear. In fact, they are colossal structures, each one tipping the scale at around a staggering 1,000,000 tons. That's right, 1,000,000 tons? Now, you might be wondering how something so heavy can just float in the sky. Well, it has everything to do with density. Imagine an average cloud about a cubic kilometer in volume. This cloud has a density of around 1.003 kilograms per cubic meter. In simpler terms, it's just a little bit lighter than the air around it, about 0.4% lighter, to be exact. It's this slight difference in density that gives the cloud its buoyancy, allowing it to float majestically in the sky. It's a lot like how a balloon filled with helium floats in the air. The helium inside the balloon is less dense than the air outside, giving it the lift it needs to float. But here's the kicker. Even though the density of the cloud is only slightly less than the air around it, the sheer size of the cloud means that it contains an enormous amount of water. In fact, if you were to take all the water in an average cloud and put it into a container, that container would have to be the size of a large sports stadium. So, those seemingly light and fluffy clouds are in actuality gargantuan water balloons floating in the sky, each one holding enough water to fill a stadium. Next time you're laying on the grass, daydreaming and watching the clouds drift by, remember this fun fact. Those fluffy white clouds are not just simple water vapor formations. They're 1,000,000-ton floating water balloons, each one a marvel of nature's engineering. So next time you're daydreaming, staring at those fluffy white clouds, remember, they're basically 1,000,000-ton floating water balloons. Ever thought you're having a bad day? Well, spare a thought for our long-necked friends, the giraffes. Now, these towering creatures have a bit of a shocking problem. You see, it's not easy being the tallest animal in the savanna, especially when it comes to lightning storms. In fact, giraffes are 30 times more likely to get hit by lightning than us humans. Between the years of 1996 and 2010, there were only 5 well-documented fatal lightning strikes on giraffes. Doesn't sound like much, does it? But when you consider that the giraffe population was only around 140,000 during this time, those 5 strikes suddenly seem a lot more significant. In fact, the giraffe fatality rate due to lightning is about 0.003 deaths per 1,000 giraffes each year. So the next time you're caught in a storm, remember, at least you're not a giraffe. You know how they say identical twins are exactly the same? Well, they lied. Yes, you heard it right. Identical twins may share the same DNA, but when it comes to fingerprints, they're as unique as snowflakes. This difference is all thanks to environmental factors during development in the womb. Here's the science behind it. While the genetic blueprint is identical for twins, the way they interact with their environment in the womb is unique. Factors such as umbilical cord length, position in the womb, and the rate of finger growth all play a role in shaping those intricate swirls and loops on your fingertips. So, while twins may share a striking resemblance, their fingerprints tell a different story. Each pattern is a unique code, a signature of individuality. That means, even in the world of identical twins, there's no escaping your own identity. So, if you're an identical twin planning some mischief, remember, your twin's not taking the fall for you. Ever wished there were more hours in a day? Well, Mother Nature's working on it. Now, don't get too excited just yet. This isn't going to be an overnight change. In fact, it's a process that's been going on for centuries and will continue for billions more. You see, our home planet, the Earth, is a bit of a slowpoke. It's not spinning as fast as it used to. Imagine a figure skater spinning on ice. When they extend their arms out, they move slower, right? This is due to the conservation of angular momentum, and Earth is a bit like that skater. Over time, the pull of the moon and the sun, along with other factors, have been causing our planet to gradually slow down in its rotation. So what does this mean for us? Well, it means that our days are actually getting longer. But don't start planning what you're going to do with your extra time just yet. We're talking about an increase of approximately 1.8 seconds every 100 years. So it's not something we'll notice in our lifetime or even in the next few hundred generations. To put things into perspective, let's take a little trip back in time. About 600 million years ago, back when the first multicellular life was just starting to appear, a day on Earth lasted only 21 hours. That's 3 hours less than what we have now. Now, if we were to continue this trend into the future, scientists estimate that in about 3.3 billion years from now, a day on Earth will last 25 hours. That's right, an extra hour in your day. But remember, we're talking billions of years here. So don't start adjusting your watches just yet. So next time you find yourself wishing for more hours in the day, just remember, Earth's got your back. It's slowly but surely working on giving you that extra time. It's just going to take a little while, a few billion years, give or take. So, in about 3.3 billion years, you'll finally have that 25-hour day you've been dreaming of. Ever feel like your brain's eating itself? Well, guess what? It is. No, don't panic. This isn't a zombie movie plot. It's a natural process called phagocytosis. It's a bit like a cleanup operation where cells in your brain envelop and consume smaller cells or molecules. Picture a Pac-Man game happening inside your head, with your brain cells playing the role of Pac-Man, chomping away at the little intruders. It might sound a bit unnerving, but this process is actually crucial for maintaining the health of your brain. It helps clear out unnecessary or potentially harmful components, and keeps your gray matter in tip-top shape. So, while it may sound like a horror story, it's really more of a maintenance routine. So the next time you're feeling a little brain dead, just remember, your brain's just having a snack. Ever wondered what color the universe is? No, well, we're going to tell you anyway. Buckle up, because this is going to be a creamy ride into the cosmos. Back in 2002, a group of astronomers decided to get a bit artsy. They embarked on a mission to find out the average color of the universe. Yes, you heard that right. They gathered light from over 200,000 galaxies and averaged the color values. And the result? A color that's not quite white, not quite brown, but a creamy beige, a shade they humorously dubbed Cosmic Latte. Picture, if you will, a universe-sized latte, lightly frothed, gently warming the expanse of space. This isn't your usual stellar story, but it's an intriguing one nonetheless. So, the next time you gaze up at the night sky, remember, you're essentially looking at an enormous, celestial coffee cup. So, there you have it. The universe isn't black, it's not blue, it's not even rainbow colored. Nope, it's just beige. Ever wish you could slow down time? Maybe you should try being a lizard. Now I know what you're thinking, how can a lizard, or any animal for that matter, experience time differently than we do? Well, let's dive into the fascinating world of animal time perception. You see, it all boils down to how quickly the brain can process incoming information. For us humans, our brains chug along at a pretty standard speed, taking in and processing information from our five senses. But for smaller creatures like lizards and salamanders, their brains work overtime, processing information at a much faster rate. Imagine you're a lizard lounging on a rock in the sun. To you, everything around you seems to move in slow motion. The bird soaring overhead seems to hang in the sky, the leaves rustling in the wind seem to sway leisurely, and the seconds tick by like minutes. Your brain is picking up and processing every little detail so quickly that time appears to slow down. Meanwhile, larger animals like cats and dogs perceive time at a pace closer to ours. Their brains process information more slowly than a lizard's, but faster than ours. So for them, time might seem to pass at just the right speed. Now, you might be thinking, great, I'll just become a lizard and enjoy my leisurely life in slow motion. Well, not so fast. This heightened perception of time comes with a trade-off. These animals also have faster metabolisms, meaning they need to eat more frequently. So, while you're enjoying your leisurely sunbathe, you're also constantly on the hunt for your next meal. It's a complex and fascinating world out there, with each creature experiencing life in its own unique way. And while we can't literally slow down time, understanding how other creatures perceive it can give us a fresh perspective on our own lives. So, if you're ever feeling rushed, just remember, in lizard time, you've got all the time in the world. Well, folks, we've had quite the journey today, haven't we? We've learned that clouds are not just fluffy cotton candy in the sky, but million-ton behemoths. We've empathized with our long-necked friends, the giraffes, who are 30 times more likely to be struck by lightning than us. We've discovered that identical twins can't pull a switcheroo when it comes to fingerprints, thanks to their unique womb environments. We found out that our Earth is a bit of a slowpoke, taking its sweet time to rotate, adding an extra 1.8 seconds every century. We've delved into the brain's strange dining habits, constantly nibbling on itself in a process called phagocytosis. We've marveled at the universe's average color, the cosmic latte. And lastly, we've learned that how we perceive time might be totally different for a lizard or a salamander. So next time you're staring at a cloud, remember it's a million-ton water balloon. And if you're caught in a storm, be grateful you're not a giraffe. And remember, you're unique, even if you're an identical twin. As for time, well, it's all a matter of perspective. And whatever you do, don't forget. The universe is beige and your brain is always hungry.